Like, did the trailer match your series expectations?
Definitely.
It outdid it,
It
honestly.
outdid it. Namaste, Dharti Vasio.
Welcome to our channel. I'm Sweetie.
Nemo here.
So, guys, you're wondering that what is this chillax environment?
So, we just had a thought in mind. Like, we absolutely love K-dramas and other dramas in general, and we love discussing them.
Yes, yes,
And
yes.
we discuss a lot after watching
Yes,
dramas,
yes.
right? So we thought, like, why not we just discuss it with you guys,
Yeah.
have this super engaging
Yeah.
theories and all
Yeah.
that, which will be
Yeah.
fun.
Yeah.
And you guys can tag along by commenting, so it's going to be a new experience, a
Yeah.
new way of expressing
Yeah.
ourselves
Yeah.
and how we love the dramas.
So basically, we are going to have a raw discussion, guys. Like, we are like literally dressed up in our pajamas and we are gonna sip on our green teas and we are just basically going to talk. It's going to be a free discussion. It's the way how me and my sister talk. So today, guys, we are going to discuss about one of the greatest Netflix series right now on the earth.
And if you have been following us, we just did the trailer,
Yeah.
and then what happened was we binge
Oh,
watched.
yeah.
And
Oh,
we binge watch
yes.
like
Yes, yes,
anything,
yes,
like everywhere, even in the bathroom. Like, I
yes.
couldn't
Yes,
just keep my phone down.
yeah. The
And the series is
Squid Game. So, Squid Game is number one in more than 80 countries right
Yes,
now.
when we did the trailer, Squid Game was trending on number 5 in India, and
Yeah.
now it has gone to number
One
1.
in India.
That's amazing.
Yeah. So, like, I would like to ask you first that what rating would you give to Squid Game out of 10?
I would probably give it a 8.5, right? Eight point five because not 10, but 8.5 because Squid Game is as amazing, very engaging and fun to watch. But also, it has borrowed a lot of idea because this concept has been already done, right? The execution of the concept is amazing, but it's already been done. So for originality, maybe a point less,
Yeah.
but it's so well done, right? This concept of survival game, it's a mixture of lot of things. Hunger Games, then
Exactly. It's
Black
not
Mirror.
a
Then I've
completely
also read that Alice in Borderland, it's been drawn a lot of inspiration from this Japanese series, which made me interested in this Japanese series. Before I ask you, where are the teas?
Yeah, yeah, exactly. So sorry.
I've been waiting for,
Here you go.
yes, something to sip along. That's
Okay.
nice. Makes it more cozy now.
Okay. So for me, the rating I would give would be 9.5 out of 10. Okay, so the reason behind is that Squid Game, though it's a survival game and a lot of people have made series on it and everything, but Squid Games makes you really think after the series. Okay, so the characters and the experience that they're going through is something that I'll tell you later that how we can relate it to in real life, right? So for me, because this series makes me think a lot, even while watching and even after watching it.
Yeah, so as you said, it also made me think a lot. And there were a lot of hidden meanings which I was contemplating throughout the series, which after when we finished watching it, I did a bit of Googling and all that. What I was thinking was interpreting was, and a lot of things were like, matched what was I was thinking, Yes, there's a lot of metaphors, there's a lot of indications in the series which actually makes you think why the plot is going on. Like, why is Ilnam there, right? All of them are in the age of, that's the first thing which came in my mind, right?
Because he's too
Two,
old.
he's too old.
He's too
It's the
old.
first thing which came in my mind when Ji Yoon enters the competition, right? And he wakes up And the first person he sees is the Ilnam counting.
Yeah.
Right.
Yeah. Yeah. Yeah.
And that's when it came in my mind, like, all of them seem to be in middle age or young.
Yeah.
But Ilnam is like only person is too old in the series.
Too old.
Right. I guess on 70, 80s or more than that.
More than that.
Yes. Yeah. So that, and second was that he's number one.
Yeah. Yeah,
right?
He's the number one.
Why is he number one? It means that they approached him, the first person to
approach.
Exactly,
yeah.
And why was he approached first?
Exactly.
Right? So that was the thing which was going along the head, you know? So, yeah, it's so many things which are happening based on Ilnam itself, which of course we come to know, we get a clarity in the end.
Yeah.
Right?
Yeah. So, like, did the trailer matched your series expectations?
Definitely.
It outdid it, honestly.
It outdid it. Like, yes, we knew it was a survival game, a money-based game, and we know people are going to get killed.
Exactly.
But the character build-up is so nice that you actually start feeling for the characters.
Yeah, yeah.
And the amazing, brilliant part of it is it's just 9 episodes.
Yeah, yeah. 9 episodes.
Yes. 9 episodes and you get so involved in the characters.
It's from the beginning, so it's like 9 episodes, right? So there is not so much time to waste. So from the beginning, it's a very direct series, right?
Yes.
And I think that's why the series became number one.
Yeah, it makes it binge watch, you know. It's not like 100 episodes.
Yeah, it's not like your typical...
You finish it in a day.
Yeah, it's not like your K-drama where there is a time where, you know, there is a time to kill, time to waste.
Yeah.
Where, not like exactly waste. By waste, I mean, you know, like, there can be time where you can add a lot of romantic scenes and there can be a time where you can add sad scenes and this and that. But
yeah, I mean, in general, K-drama's episodes are like 1-1.5 hour long. Right? And Squid Game is also episodes are around 1 hour long.
Yeah. Yeah.
But
40, 50.
Yeah. But the thing is that it moves very fast. And that is why it becomes very binge-worthy. So there is not much time, you know, even in deaths and everything. You know, they just pick up the
bodies
and
they
incinerate it.
Yeah.
That's it. Done. No time to sit
exactly.
and cry.
That's why we think that that's why the series became number one. First of all, 9 episodes. Secondly, to the point. So honestly, even if you binge watch, the series might get over in 2 days.
I watched it in 1.5
days. Yeah, max 3 days. Like, you know, if you're like still have some things to do and, you know, so I'll give you max 3 to 4 days, not more than that.
Yes, it's a very binge watch. I mean, we don't need to say it, people are already watching it and we love the series, and that's why we are going to discuss the heck out of it, right?
So like, who is your, like, relatable character in the series?
Relatable?
Yeah, your favorite or relatable. And you can just pick one, not two. Just one.
I have no favorites or relatable character.
Okay.
Like,
even if you think from a survival game point of view.
No, none.
None.
None. None comes to my mind because it moves so fast that I don't have time to choose one.
Okay.
Right. Like, I understand the emotional depth of the characters and where they come from. But I mean, yes, Gi-hun goes to the point. If you ask me, like, really whom, because he is shown such kind of character who is very lousy and lame and, you know, a gambling addict.
Yeah. Yeah.
Right. And then the way he uses his head to just, when, you know, when he goes into the survival mode.
Yeah.
And the way he contemplates and, you know, to survive.
He uses his logic too.
Yes. Exactly. A lot of logic, you know. Despite of, and the best example would be for this is that Honeycomb
game.
Yeah.
Yeah.
So there we see that he is actually very childish sort of, you know, and he picks the, he's not able to understand, whereas Sang-woo understands the game beforehand.
Yeah. So
when he sees.
So you can say Sang-woo is book smart.
Yes.
And Gi-hun is street smart.
Yes. So the way his survival instinct works is very interesting to see. So yes, a little bit favoritism, but I in general would not pick favorites because all of them are important, you know, like you won't have Gi-hun winning if there are no other people to kill.
Okay.
Right?
Okay.
So they're as much important.
And any character you dislike?
Honestly, Sang-woo a bit.
Okay.
Because he's too mean sometimes. Okay. He's playing very, very...
He's my favorite though. I'll explain. I'll tell you later.
Yeah, he's playing very seriously this game for survival.
Okay, so for me, my...
It breaks a bit hard when he kills early that way. So that is the only reason.
So for me, it would be Sang-woo, actor Park Hae-soo, my favorite character, and I would relate with him the most. Because, first of all, he's in survival game, and that is the point he makes straight into his head.
Yeah.
Right?
Yeah.
And for being in a survival game, okay, he feels guilty from time to time. We have seen that, you know, he sits silently and he thinks. But, like, the best part about him is that he's like, it's a survival game and it's okay if people are like, even if I have to kill someone. Right? So that's why I'm very relatable to him. He's very straightforward. He's straightforward when it comes to survival game. And I think that mindset is really important in Squid Game.
Yes, but then he does become emotional in the end.
He does.
And where he could have won the series, if that's where the thing is. If he had this straight survival instinct, which he played along, he could have just won the game.
That's the thing. Even I felt that he should have continued it.
So, it was a clear-cut his win. Mm-hmm. But he let Gi-hun play it.
Yeah, exactly. Exactly.
In fact, Gi-hun wanted to stop the game. He didn't want to lose the friend and all.
Yeah.
But he is the one who, you know.
Yeah.
So.
Yeah. So, even ending.
Somewhere there is this irony in his character. Mm-hmm. Although he's shown very crude and harsh and to the point. But in the end, it all changes.
He gives up.
He doesn't give up. He thinks that's the better option. Because in this way, he'll at least able to clear off his mom's debt.
Yeah. And the character, it's not a disliking thing. But I'm strictly saying from the survival point of game would be Elise. Like, the way he plays is nice.
He's very naive. He's shown very naive.
But it's a survival game. You cannot trust anyone.
But that's the thing. The survival game doesn't work on, you know, people just being...
Yeah.
If everyone is straightforward, then...
It would be like...
Too simple. You know? Just kill off each other and the game finishes. But that's the thing. How the game manipulates all these different kind of personalities... How it manipulates someone who is very naive, someone who is very street smart, someone who is very book smart.
Someone very trustworthy, like Ali.
Yes. So such kind of complex characters makes it so interesting to watch. Like, what are they thinking? How are they going to react in each situation? Mm-hmm. Right?
So, yeah, exactly. So for me, and guys, please note, we are just saying it's this strictly from a survival game point of view. And honestly, like, I loved Ali's role.
Yes.
Anupam Tripathi, well done. Congratulations. Like, you have really, like, come so far. Yes.
Like, he makes you believe that he's so naive and so, you know, in so much trouble that he has to
and enter till this. And to the end, he was like to Sang-woo, like, you know, this is that you helped me. So, you know, like, take this, share this. He actually considered Sang-woo as his elder brother. And that's where the game also makes you believe that, you know, don't trust. Hmm. It's one of the point of Squid Game is do not trust anyone.
That's basically exploring the human nature.
Yeah, exactly.
Like, in your survival instinct, it's no relation matter, nothing, because you have to survive.
Exactly.
Okay. So, any favorite episodes or scenes which you have, like, you know, which had a very big impact on you, right?
Impact, okay. So, number...
Or any turning point in something which was very exciting, like what?
So, I would go with number one. The scene that I like the most is when Sang-woo betrays Ali. And when he walks away. And it's like the gun firing and number 199 eliminated.
Yes.
That scene touches you so much. That scene touches you so much. That teaches you to not trust anyone.
Right.
In a game.
That is what it is. These kind of survival games explore human nature at its worst. You know? Like, you need to survive.
Mm.
So you will, it's no more relation, it's no more this, you need to
survive. Exactly.
You know, it's raw, it's
exactly thing. Exactly. So,
somewhere it was expected that Sang-woo is going to do that.
Yeah, obviously, in that episode, you got the hint.
Yes, it was expected that he's going to
betray
people. Mm. That's how his character got developed.
Mm.
Right.
And one more is the last ending scene. When they finally, there is this ground and there is that squid drawn. The scene starts with the Squid Game,
and
the final game is the Squid Game. And the opening of that scene, I really loved it. So for me, these things are like, you know, it's like what you played in your childhood is that the, and it's the final game now.
Right. So in this series overall, I don't have a favorite scene or something which impacted me. Yes, it does make you think a lot. But the most thing I like about how the subtle things which they were portraying about, you know, metaphors for society.
Yeah.
Like, you know, all the soldiers were controlling, were wearing red.
Mm-hmm.
And all the one who weren't were subjects, were wearing green.
Green.
Right? So you see this contrasting red and green.
Mm-hmm.
You see this going on everywhere in the series.
Yeah.
This big contrast. Red meaning power, green meaning, you know, poor or submission.
And
or
the
whatever.
Black is the...
Yeah. So such kind of metaphors you have. Then we also have the best part which makes Squid Game stand apart from others is, I think, the games.
Games.
Right?
And
Squid Game is not a game which we play, as in India somewhere.
No.
So it's very unique to Korea.
Yeah.
Then Honeycomb is another interesting thing, which we don't have it, but they have it.
Yeah.
And it was very interesting to watch how they twisted it into a survival game.
Yeah.
Green Light, Red Light, yes, we do have versions which we have played. So Green it's Light. Not a new thing.
Yeah.
And what were the other games?
Tug of War
is a very common game. So yes, this few games which made it very outstanding, you know, very interesting to watch.
And the thing that they jump, you know, on the glass.
Yeah. So it's
thing.
Type of thing which we used to play.
Yeah.
You know.
We had a different version of like chip and we used to like do it with one.
No, I think that version all across the world has been played. This was
different.
Modified to kill,
and,
you know.
And the amazing point that we missed, I mean didn't miss out, like we wanted to like tell you guys, is how cruel is the human nature.
Mm.
Money, like rich people.
That's the whole point of the series.
Rich people got bored and then they started like, you know, I mean, the Il-nam said really amazing thing. Like the poor people and rich people, in the end, you get bored with your lifestyle.
Hmm.
And since there is an excess of money, so rich people made this game of actually making this as kind of a horse race.
Hmm.
That the metaphor that he gave, a horse race.
Right. Yeah, so it's very deep in this way. So that is why I think the series, you know, starts. Plus, a very twisted Il-nam, which, you know, again, this metaphor. Il-nam is number one. And Gi-hun, who wins the race from bottom to top, goes to number one, is 456 number. He's the last
number.
So how he's climbed up his journey to go to number one and then crash land a reality. Like, what?
Yeah.
That was a very stupid reason to have this game.
Yeah.
Right?
Yeah. Just because rich people got bored. Yeah.
Wow.
So.
We are again in deep thoughts and processes.
Yeah. Yeah. So with that, I want to say that how like Squid Game actually like it impacted me and how we can relate that in real life too.
Mm.
So like, did you got like impacted with the series?
Not much really. Yes, there's a few hours hangover after it gets finished. Like you are thinking like, what now? Because the series ends in a cliffhanger. The series doesn't end. It ends in us probably hinting at season 2.
Mm-hmm.
Right? We don't know what happens of Jin-ho, the inspector. Because he's shot in the shoulder. He's not shot in the heart. And he just falls in the sea. There is no dead body. A, we don't know what happens to him. B, Gi-hun then just stops going. He's on his way to go to US to meet the daughter. But then he turns away and, you know, is now on a motive to stop this, you know, horrible thing. So these are the few points. Then frontman's character is very less shown. Like, why he does this? What is the motive behind frontman? I mean, we know why the rich people do it. Why Illam did it, but we don't know what is frontman's position on this. So lot of loose ends, and that is why you are in the hangover of the series, like what is going to happen. In such, it didn't impact me because we already know the harsh truth of life. You know, like this is how poor people are, and this is the kind of irony we live in. You know? So yes, it makes you think, but no, it didn't impacted my life as such.
Okay. So for me, because of my nature, I am a slightly sensitive person, and like I actually, after, even when I was watching it, and even after I finished Squid Game, like at least for 4 to 5 days, whenever I was sleeping, I got Squid Game in my dreams. Maybe my subconscious took it, like it absorbed it too much. I literally got dreams of Squid Game. And even after like watching the series, I told you, right? The scenes that disturbed me was selling body parts.
Right.
Even after the person is
But that is the best thing. Like in most survival games, this doesn't happen. This was the good part of Squid Game. Like how even in the worst situation, people can make it worse.
Yeah.
You know, there's no word as worse, but just consider, you know, worst. If people are dying out of misery and it doesn't matter, you need to make most of the situation. So you start selling body parts.
So,
and that is how intense and cruel human nature can be.
Yeah. So it's always has been in my nature, even when I was a child or even today, if I hear some gruesome things, my brain will automatically imagine it. My brain will go like, how much pain they might be in? How can someone do this? These questions will keep popping in my head till everything is like calmed down. So for me, yeah, it has impacted my subconscious, but now I'm fine, obviously. So yeah, again, if you're a very highly sensitive person, don't watch it then.
There's a lot of gore. Okay.
Yeah, don't watch it then.
So you can either skip the part or... You know,
yeah,
I mean,
don't.
Yes, it plays a lot of with human emotions.
Yeah.
You know, and on the other hand, we have this very sensitive Ali, to very straightforward Sang-woo. Then
and
there is
Sebo too.
Yeah, Sebo. Yeah, she has another story of her going on, but you know, all she cares about her brother and her family to, you know, somehow survive. There's another part. Gi-hun is another part, and so many emotions going throughout the series, and how people react to it makes you do wonder, like, what if, you know, situation and could have been turned or and there's a lot of gore, so that's one thing. I think from episode 5, 6, 7 something,
no episode 3 and 4 it starts
somewhere around that. So there's a lot of gore and mutilation happening, which might be very sensitive to some people, but yes, in general it is very enjoyable to watch.
And a simple thing like how, like, I can relate it in my daily life is that, for example, you take a very basic office scenario. There you'll find Illam, who knows everything. There you'll find Sang-woo, who can do anything to get the promotion. Then there is the guy like Ali, who will trust everybody in the office and people can walk on him. Then there is Gi-hun, who is like the teamwork guy, who wants the entire team to participate and be equally like...
Yeah, so you have this... arrays of character. Even the character of I forgot her name.
No.
The other female supporting character. The gangster and the woman.
Gangster's name in the series was Doksu.
And the woman, I forgot her name.
Mi-hyun, something like that.
Yes, something like that. So her character also gave a separate, a different kind of character, where she's shown very cunning and, you know, this, and also shown very miserable.
She's basically Miss, but she's cunning. It's like basically she's what we say, two-sided people.
Yes, yes, two-sided. Will do anything to, you know, just to get the thing done.
Yeah.
So yeah, we have a lot of.
Whereas Sebok is that she has this goal. She's like, I want to get it, but
she'll get it her way.
Without disturbing anybody.
Yeah.
Yeah.
So yeah, you have a lot of characters and a lot of emotions and what. So it might impact people. Like, and
the
it did.
Biggest lesson is money, the biggest motivator.
Yes, money is everything.
Money is the biggest. Yeah, in real life also we read the news like how people are murdering, like son is killing his dad. Yeah,
that's what the thing is. This survival games evoke so many emotions because it is a metaphor for real life, you know. It just shows the real picture. Like in real life, there are so many people involved and things are hidden. But survival game, there is the money. This is what you have to do. And people will do it anything for it. Mm. Right? Right. So now let's wrap up.
Yeah, so like the wrap-up. So
what to take from this series is it's great binge watch. It's a short series. We are expecting a season 2. And we hope it comes soon.
Yeah.
Overall, very enjoyable.
Yeah. And if you are like, I can still bear it, but if you are honestly a very highly sensitive person, and for you, even if it takes months or it might seriously impact you, then I won't suggest you to watch it. I won't suggest you to watch it. And with that, guys, comment down below what you think. And we would love to discuss more with you in comment section.
Right.
Yeah, because such things really intrigues us.
Yeah, there are a lot of theories. So, no, I'll tell you a fun fact that it came across late, but the area which they were sleeping in, the walls were white and there were some pictures drawn on it.
Those were actually
the games which they were going to be played. Yeah, yeah. And it only gets revealed when more and more people die. You know, the beds go and then you actually see oh god.
Yeah.
They don't need to guess the game. They have been drawn. Already there. So such fun things in the game, in the series.
They were in their own thinking space and they never realized it.
Yeah, that's again a metaphor. Things are in front of you.
Hmm.
But you are not, you're just blinded by so many things which are happening.
So money is the motivator. Kill or get killed. Yeah, so guys, this was a very in-depth discussion. And if you have any views, comment down below. Thank you so much for watching. If you have stayed with us up till now.
Thank you.
Thank you. Like, you're a very patient person. Thank you. So, see you soon.
Bye.
Bye.